Do you want perfect, universal and powerful Hackintosh, which can handle 4 to 8K video editing, heavy music production, 3D rendering, which can handle simply anything you want? Something like the 12-core Mac Pro, but significantly cheaper? Then this video is the right for you. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonaut.cloud and I help people to save money on their Hackintosh builds. I help them simply to build the perfect Hackintosh. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. This Hackintosh build I will show you today is not just 12-core Mac Pro killer. It's even faster than the latest 8-core iMac Pro, which you will see later in this video. I used this Hackintosh build as my main production machine for last year. And believe me, I really hate to be limited by anything in any way. So I built this Hackintosh to be the first computer that's waiting for me and not me waiting for my computer. Oof, what a pleasure! It's simply built which must satisfy anybody. I will show you and explain what components I chose and why. I will show you how it looks. I will show you benchmark scores, and at the end I will give you some useful tips. As you know already, the most important part of Hackintosh is the motherboard. I chose the Gigabyte Aorus G370 Gaming 5 motherboard, which I tested a lot and verified and found it to be one of the best Hackintosh motherboards available. It can handle up to 64GB of RAM, and its CPU support goes up to Intel Core i9-9900K, so plenty room for upgrades. It has support for Thunderbolt 3, but you would need to buy additional Alpine Ridge or Titan Ridge PCI Express expansion card. For CPU, I chose Intel Core i7-8700K. Its 6 cores and 12 threads is far enough for 99% of people. I don't overclock, but on internet you can see a lot of success with overclocking even beyond 5 GHz. By my opinion, it has great price to performance ratio value. 8 and 9 gen CPUs are known to run quite hot, so I paired this i7-8700K with the Kraken X62 280mm water cooler. My temperatures never exceeded 65 degrees of Celsius. For memory, I chose 64GB G-Scale DDR4 3200MHz CL14 Trident Z because it's simply insanely fast. This memory is not on this motherboard's QVL, so in 4-stick configuration it is not officially supported, so I had to slightly tweak its timings. If you plan just 2 16GB sticks, so in total 32GB, then this memory will run great at advertised speed and timings, without any tweaking. This configuration depends on your own needs and workflow, so what I found as the best for my mainly video editing may not be the best for you. I have Samsung 860 EVO as a boot SSD for system and applications, Samsung 970 EVO NVMe M.2 for my source media, mostly video files, and second SSD Samsung 860 EVO for my cache files. In this setup, I can work even with 8K files without any problems. Again, it all depends on correct workflow, correct codecs, correct applications, and so on. So if you would want some advice or help with video editing or audio workstation setup, just reach me at my Patreon. Link is now in this video description. Finally, as a GPU, I chose Vega Frontier Edition with 16GB of VRAM. It's an ultimate card which in some tasks beats even the Nvidia Titan XP in professional applications. Simply this Vega for video editing with massive color corrections is absolute monster. I'm preparing some videos with comparison of performance in video editing on several systems, including my newest i9 Hackintosh build, so today I just show you what still most of you want, synthetic benchmarks. I wanna mention that despite all PC users are a little bit obsessed with benchmarks, in fact those benchmarks has simply nothing to do with real life performance, and that's exactly where macOS shines. Look at iPhones for example. When some PC guy see specifications of some iPhone, like with just one or two cores, 2 or 3 gigs of RAM, he will say, oh, what a crap. But in real life, the old iPhone is still snappier than their newer Android phone. And that's exactly the same on macOS. Especially macOS Mojave is the most powerful system I could be working with. So, let's stop talking and go straight to those benchmarks. So, let's do a summary. Fastest Mac Pro in single-core performance is the 8-core model with Geekbench score 3,851 points. This Intel Core i7-8700K 6-core Hackintosh build in 2019 beats the Mac Pro with quite 2 times better score, 6,403. In multi-core performance, 12-core Mac Pro score is 27,214. This Hackintosh base score is 29,700, so 2,500 points faster. Should I compare it to the latest 8-core iMac Pro? Let's have a look. 8-core iMac Pro single-score Geekbench performance is 5,057 against this Hackintosh score 6,509. In multi-core performance, 8-core iMac Pro scores 31,090. This Hackintosh 29,700, so a little bit lower. But you can easily in just few clicks in BIOS slightly overclock it. Let's have a look. It's just really few clicks to overclock it to 4.8 GHz and bang! Now you get score 31,689, which is higher than the 8-core iMac Pro. And I overclocked the CPU only a little bit, you can go even further. So, as you could see, this Intel Core i7-8700K 6-core macOS Mojave Hackintosh build in 2019 can beat the 12-core Mac Pro and even the latest 8-core iMac Pro for a lot less money. Apple still offers 12-core Mac Pro for $6,399 with same amount of RAM, and 8-core iMac Pro with 64 gigs of RAM and just Vega 56 for $5,799. So this Hackintosh is $4,000 cheaper than the top specs Mac Pro and $3,400 cheaper than the iMac Pro, but has higher performance. Yes, iMac Pro has 5K display included. So I think for those saved $3,400, you can buy several 5K displays. Oof, this is huge savings on money. But the biggest advantage is, if some of your components die after warranty, you will just go to first PC parts shop and buy another for cheap. When something die in your Mac, repair would cost the same as the new Mac. So you can only cry. Because I stepped up a few weeks ago one level and built a new monster Hackintosh with Intel Core i9-9900K processor and Z390 motherboard, I transformed this i7 build into some kind of backup machine. lowered the RAM, and instead of Vega Frontier Edition, I paired it with Sapphire Nitro Plus RX 588GB. So this is how it looks now. And again, as my thanks to my supporters, you can find now in this video description complete, already prepared and tweaked EFI Clever folder for these two configurations as a free gift from mine. So you don't need to know anything about how to build a Hackintosh, just buy those components listed in this video description, follow my tutorial, again in video description, download my whole EFI folder, copy it to your EFI partition and your Hackintosh will be up and running at 100% in just an hour. If you want to unlock full potential of this build and don't want to any bottleneck, I would advise to pair it with AMD Vega GPU, especially those who want to do video editing on it. But most of you will be happy even with the RX 580. If your intent is to build a Hackintosh for music production, then you can stick even with only the integrated GPU without any dedicated. When people ask me what components would be great for audio or video production, I always answer it depends. It really mostly depends on your own workflow. To editors who works in Final Cut Pro 10, I would advise different disk setup than for those who works in DaVinci Resolve. The same applies to audio editing. Different setup would be for those who records live 30 tracks with low latency, and different setup for those who are just editing and used mostly massive virtual instruments with tons of gigabytes large sound banks. Different setup would be for insane video colorists and different for some YouTube hobbyists. So there is no single answer. If you want to build a balanced editing system, I would advise reach me at my Patreon and we can discuss it and I can advise you components suited exactly for your needs, so you can even save some money on it. Link to my Patreon is in this video description. And it does not matter if you are Windows, macOS or Linux user. So, I hope you found in my today's video some new inspiration. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button, so more people can benefit from it. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it, so you won't miss any of my future videos. And don't forget, I don't have only one single video. I've done a lot of useful videos and tutorials already, so watch them too before asking. And please, read the video description. I always put a lot of useful information there. You can also join my Hackintosh and Macintosh groups on Facebook, Reddit or my website. Links are again now in this video description. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends.